This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
Mhm. Wieder das Übliche, okay. Hauptstadt des Besetzten, Temerien. Besetzt vom Kaiser. Hm.
It must suffice.
Think of your cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman will refer to his Imperial Majesty by his full title or not at all. The gentleman will be seated on the bergère.
The what now?
In that chair.
Hmm.
Cutwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
Ja, genau, was ist mit dem Bart los, hä?
What's wrong with my beard? Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine, do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please, and sit still.
Na toll.
How goes it? Preparations for the audience proceeding as planned?
Yes, General. The gentleman will be more or less presentable.
Who's this guy? He a barber too?
No. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Yennefer's escort. They were my men, all of them. Indeed, were. For none have returned to Vizima, have they? I truly wonder what happened on the road yesterday. Perhaps you could enlighten me. You have time. And a razor to your throat.
Hmm. Ja, frag mich da nicht so viel.
Your men died in battle, as soldiers tend to.
I see their fate does not trouble you, overly.
True, but I'm guessing the fate of those whose country they invaded didn't overly trouble them.
Nordlings, we can bathe you, shave you, and clothe you, but teaching you manners, that will be a challenge.
Nice meeting you too.
Done. Shall I shave him once more, against the grain?
No. He himself is very much against the grain. That's enough. Farewell, Witcher. Or rather, see you soon.
Hmm.
Good. Now the gentleman may dress.
Na toll, der schöne Bart. Das wird er dir büßen. Jetzt wird's persönlich.
Sadly, I did not receive exact measurements. If the garments chafe, our tailor will adjust them.
Hm. Alle Farben, sofern er schwarz ist, okay. Hm.
Black, black, or black.
We do not like garish colors in Nilfgaard. The gentleman will tell me once he has chosen an outfit.
Hm. Okay, kleid dich an und sprich mit dem Kamera. Na toll. Hm. So, was haben wir denn hier noch? Nehmen wir das hier mal mit. Warum nicht, hä? Oh, das erste Buch. Was haben wir denn hier? Die Wunde des Sirikaniens. Ungewöhnliche Orte gesehen, die urtümliche Wildnis von Brokkilon mit ihren Bäumen, die so hoch sind, dass die Wipfeln in den Wolken verschwinden, Zwergenhöhlen, die tief im Barbara. Der Nestpalast von Pontvanis. Okay, interessant. Das ist ja wieder das recht berüchtigte Sirikanien. So. Ich werde das jetzt nicht vorlesen.
A shame I have no time.
Ja, ist echt schade. Ist echt schade. Opposition von Nilfgaard. Okay, interessant. Was haben wir denn noch hier? Ist hier noch ein Buch? Gnomische Scherze. Was für ein Scherz. Okay, interessant. Was haben wir hier? Ein Schwert gegen Hexen. Aber wirklich. Ach so. Da geht's dann weiter, okay. Was haben wir denn hier noch? Irgendwas. Nicht, okay. Was nehmen wir denn? Okay, links oder rechts? Das in der Mitte ist bäh. Ich nehme das hier. Moment, hallo. Umdrehen, so. Gut. Hab mich entschieden, dann kann ich alles mitnehmen. Okay. Warum nicht? Höflingswam, so heißt er. So. Okay.
Black suits the gentleman. Does the outfit satisfy the gentleman?
Das geht. Schätze schon.
A studded doublet and a sword on my back, that's what would satisfy me. But tough, when in Nilfgaard.
Yes?
It's a saying. So what now? Powder my nose?
No need. The gentleman's complexion is light enough. The gentleman is to stand before the ruler of the north and south. I must confirm that he knows how to bow.
Fuck, he says. Bitte sehr, ich bin kein Wildschwein, was?
Confirm away.
Please watch. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse. Please, this is neither the time nor the place for such antics.
Schade.
The gentleman will watch carefully.
Mach noch einmal.
Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse.
Na, was war's? Ja.
Gotta be kidding.
Not at all.
Was ist passiert?
Does the gentleman know the penalty for breaches of
etiquette
in the emperor's presence? 200 lashes.
Was wurde jetzt gesagt? Wurde rausgetappt?
I do not wish that upon him, so I will not let him leave until I am confident that he knows how to behave.
Oh Mann, da ist hat sich eine Festplatte verabschiedet. Aber zum Glück nicht die Aufnahmefestplatte. Okay, was war jetzt los? Die wünsche ich mir nicht, da wird ich eine. Ach, willst du mich verarschen? Okay, linkes Bein vorne, das Scheiß dahin.
Lacking fluidity and grace. But we've learned to expect less of Nordlings.
Was für ein Bullshit. Okay, ich kann es kaum erwarten, bis die weg sind. Was zum Teufel?
The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch-Magnificency.
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition.
Scheiß doch auf ihn.
Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly and with respect.
Okay, was auch immer.
Im Grimmi eb Art Kerze. Deifen Aden in Karn eb Marwut. Emir war Emreis.
Bau. Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep the Orde.
Avelian Namen, wat gern verwort. So many months at Foltest Court. Yet you still haven't mastered the basics of etiquette.
Know what they say? Can't teach an old wolf new tricks. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. Mm-hmm. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. You will find her and bring her to me.
What? Er ist der Vater von Ciri? Und sie haben sie adoptiert? Warum gerade er? Von ihm?
Are you sure? Ciri left. Went far, far away.
Do you believe I drag you here in the middle of a war to discuss a rumor?
I think anyone can be wrong, even an emperor.
I had forgotten how insolent you can be. I haven't the time to convince you, nor the desire, in fact. Yennefer will do that, after the audience.
Ja gut, machen wir's für Ciri, aber auf den da scheiß doch drauf.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
Schönes
she
Bild.
Trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you. More than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Ja, genau.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Merarid! Take him to the sorceress.
Okay, was hat er vor?
Did the gentleman not understand? Did I not emphasize adequately that one must bow to the Emperor?
Scheiß auf den.
Relax, nothing happened.
To the gentleman? But I shall be punished.
How?
Please keep close and bother no one. I've had enough breaches of etiquette for one day.
Was für ein Scheiß.
Calm yourself.
Aha, Sklaven als auch noch. Geh aus dem Weg.
I'm Herivard,
Schatz, nicht gerade hier. Okay, wer bist du denn?
Tete Take in den Kalantnäs auf Verleusau. Ep Toussaint?
Mind if I interrupt?
Why not join in instead?
We're discussing neutrality. How difficult it is to preserve.
Ja.
Know a thing or two about that.
Care to explain?
Never changes. I try to stay out of things, stand aside. Then comes an urgent summons, and an offer I can't refuse. Enough about that. Mind if we change the subject? So, talk to the Emperor.
Why did he summon you?
So not even you?
Not only am I not waiting here like some supplicant,
a name. Radzi.
Tete Take in den Kalantnäs of Verloisau. Ep Toussaint?
Mind if I interrupt?
Why not join in instead?
We're discussing neutrality. How difficult it is to preserve.
Know a thing or two about that.
Care to explain?
Never changes. I try to stay out of things, stand aside. Then comes an urgent summons, and an offer I can't refuse. Enough about that. Mind if we change the subject? So, talk to the Emperor.
Why did he summon you?
So not even you know?
No. But I wager it's an ordinary witch's contract.
Some weirbubs. See ya.
Soon, mind you.
I not request.
Svdf. Evelyn, Kata Ath. Tve Gleidevin. Svatskan.
Esma ist Trägen Äpfeltast in Karnen.
Kein Vios. Evios keines im Bail. Es ist Sand. Es war
Nordling. Schegena Tuvi.
Allied.
Barbarians. Move it!
En selfit den garfe, esse plenten et not mate. En selfit den sikjarte, kaspa ken gubelede tumeva.
Once the gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions.
Glen esse plaza.
Sharpened yet? Yes? And transcribe, the true authority in Novigrad is not the city council or the merchant's guild, but the Church of the Eternal Fire and the criminal underworld. At times it is difficult to tell the one from the other. They both display a similar ruthlessness and cynicism that...
Please wait, Your Excellency. I'm falling behind.
You know what? I'll write the report myself. You'll need only prepare a clean draft. In triplicate.
Be so kind and do not disturb. A shame I have no time. Vedimi, directly out of Nordling Tales. Inconceivable.
Geralt, that tunic, you look positively smashing.
Ugh, dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken.
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
How about that? She's grown up.
It's been years since you trained together at Kaer Morhen. A great deal has changed.
You haven't. Not a bit.
I missed those awkward compliments of yours. But let's focus on Ciri, all right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri, using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt, before the Wild Hunt does.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood, her gift. As for what the hunt wishes to do with that gift, I prefer not to think about it, really.
So where's Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places, Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently, blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Kaer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse? Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or it helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Vel and get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roamed the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.
Scars healed nicely.
A shame I have no time.
Ambassador Vaartra? Yennefer suggested I ask you about current events, the war and so on.
Of course. The Emperor's servants should keep no secrets from each other. If you will, let us approach the map.
How's the war going? I mean, apart from the fact that Nilfgaard's triumph is imminent.
I assume this to be a private conversation. We've no witnesses, so let's dispense with the propaganda, even that shrouded in irony. Our offensive was going splendidly until winter came. Edirne was in such disarray that we encountered no resistance. We had reached the Pontar before the first snows. Only a weakened Kedwin remained, and Radovid's Redania, which had ignored the rest of the North's pleas for help. We thought they'd sue for peace, perhaps even submit to vassalization. We waited for spring, certain of victory.
Radovid? Submit?
Yes, a vain hope, I agree. Radovid sent no peace envoys, nor did he advance on our positions. Instead, he trudged over the snow-bound Kestrel Mountains and attacked Kedwin, his ally. This attack took the Kedweni by surprise. They were still mourning the loss of their king. Rudderless and dejected, they laid down their arms after a few lost skirmishes and joined Radovid. And so by spring, instead of two weak enemies, we had only one powerful one.
What about Kavir?
Kavir values its neutrality. Enough not to lend its armies, or more importantly, even its coin to either side. Returning to the war, this spring there was a massive battle in the marshes of Velen. Massive, yet indecisive. Both sides suffered enormous losses, unprecedented even. Radovid has retreated across the Pontar. He's safe for now, until reinforcements arrive from the south. Then Emperor Emir Var Emrys will deal with him once and for all.
Couldn't you just go home? Save everyone a lot of marching, not to mention a few human lives.
I'm afraid the stakes are too high to fold now. We can only go all in.
How do things look in Velen?
As bad as ever. Perhaps worse. This land never flowed with milk and honey, and now it flows with blood. Armies have swept through it several times, trampling fields, looting granaries, burning villages. Famine grips the populace.
So how's ruling that earthly paradise going for you?
Not well, to be honest. Our forces are spread thin as it is, and Velen is chiefly swampy forests that are difficult to control. We've had several patrols never return to their camps. Thus, we've temporarily delegated authority in this region to a certain Nordling, a former low-ranking officer in the Temerian army, one Philip Strenger, better known by his nom de guerre, the Bloody Baron. I advise you well, avoid him.
Any news from Novigrad? Is the Free City still free?
Yes, although everyone knows this won't last. Radovid is in Oxenfurt, and the Emperor is here in Vizima, at Novigrad's doorstep, both. And both require coin and ships. Novigrad can provide these. Which is why the mood in the city is rather, well, on edge.
Meaning?
How do men deal with fear? They seek reassurance and scapegoats. The Church of the Eternal Fire understands this perfectly, and so it promises to improve the lives of its flock by pointing out the guilty. Who started the war? Who profits from it? Why, it's obvious. Mages, elves, dwarves, in a word, any and all deviants. I've been stationed in Novigrad for 13 years. First as a consul, then as ambassador. I've seen a great deal. Cruelty, cynicism, greed. But what is happening there now concerns me greatly.
What's new in Skellige?
Nothing. The islanders pride themselves on that, don't they? Doing everything according to tradition, as their forefathers did. And like their forefathers, they quarrel with each other. Pillage. Occasionally attack our transports. This is cumbersome, but nothing more. Skellige has always been a footnote to history, and so it shall remain.
Sound awfully confident. What if King Bran manages to unite the Jarls? Lead all the clans against your fleet?
King Bran is a feeble old man. From what I know, he barely remembers the names of his own vassals. Uniting all might prove difficult.
Thanks for your help.
Think nothing of it. May the great sun light your path.
How might I serve the gentleman?
By returning my things.
Citrus and cloves. The fragrance will keep the gentleman's robes fresh somewhat longer.
Thanks, bunches.
The Emperor is not known for his patience. He wants his daughter back safe and sound, as soon as possible.
Yeah, mentioned something of the sort. So long.